5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Rockets. Everyone likes them. More than 10 million people watched live as SpaceX and NASA partnered to launch two astronauts to the ISS just recently. Everyone agrees that it was phenomenal in the field of rocket science, especially the reusability of the boosters, which is an amazing piece of technology in rocket science. In this video, I am going to walk you through various systems of a rocket, step by step, and I will show you how to make one at home. Rockets are everywhere, from fireworks to rockets that launch people into space. All of them consist of four major systems based on function. The propulsion system takes up the most amount of space and consists of the fuel, oxidant, and the rocket engine itself. Next, the structural system makes up the frame that holds the rocket together and consists of the nose cone, cylindrical body, and fins. The guidance system is made up of radars, sensors, and computers that provide stability for the rocket and control maneuvers in flight. Lastly, the payload system depends on each mission and consists of anything a rocket is carrying into space, like a spacecraft, satellite, or human being. These four systems should work in coordination with each other for a successful launch. Now let's make some rockets. These rockets might be small, but they are admirably powerful, leave a cool trail of white smoke, and shoot up to 50 feet away. To make them, all you need is a box of matches, aluminium foil, and a wooden skewer. The first thing we need to do is to cut off the match heads from the matchsticks. This is not very difficult if you have a pair of cutters and a round container to collect the match heads. Next, you need a paper board and this template, which I am going to give you for free. Check the description for a link on where to get that. Just stick the body template to the paper board like this and cut around the edges. Take out the aluminum foil and tear off a sheet for the rocket body. Lay a piece of paper on top, then fold carefully the stack up 3 times. So it's 4 layers deep and just a bit larger than the template. Next, trace around the edges, then cut the shape out of all the layers at the same time. You can see that the paper prevents the aluminum foil from sticking together. Even though I can use a bamboo skewer, I decided to experiment with this single core wire instead, and the results were much better. I suggest you to experiment with different launch rods of different thickness to find out which works best for you. Next, align the aluminum foil with the template and use the markings as a guide to place the launch rod and the match head. Now slowly and carefully roll the foil tube. Remember, patience is key. Make sure to roll it tightly and neatly. When you finish rolling it, pinch the tube right above the match head and then use a pair of pliers to crimp the tip. Crimp multiple times from different angles to make a complete seal. Now our mini rocket is ready. Make sure it can move freely from the launch rod. That's how easy it is to make a mini rocket. Next, find a box and put everything in it. I poked a hole on top and our launch pad is ready. Now if you light a candle and position the flame just under the tip of the rocket, it will quickly warm the foil until the match head ignites, which you can see shoots the rocket with amazing speed and power. So it's important to be careful and avoid the temptation to point them at people or property. I would have ended the video here, but I decided to answer one important question. So safety matches are mainly made up of sulfur, antimony trisulfide, and potassium chlorate. Potassium chlorate is an oxidizer, so when heated, it releases oxygen. The sulfur burns in the presence of oxygen to produce sulfur dioxide. The antimony trisulfate acts as an accelerant and a large amount of energy is released quickly, which makes the air expand and pushes air out, which propels the rocket forward. Well, now you know about the various systems of a rocket, how to make a mini rocket, and the science behind it. So that's all I have for you today. If you enjoyed this video, maybe you will enjoy some of my others. Make sure to check them out.